The topic is graphing a function of two variables. All right, question A, sketch at least four labeled contours for f of x, y equal x squared plus y squared. Definition says a contour at z equals c is the set of all x, y's such that f of x, y is equal c. So a contour at z equals c is the set of all x, y's such that f of x, y's in our case is x squared plus y squared equals c. All right, so so let's sketch some of them. So let's c equal 0. This is going to give us x squared plus y squared is equal 0. That means that x is equal 0 and y equals 0. Right? It's the only way for x squared plus y squared to be 0. So we get a point. So basically at c equals 0, we get this point. So this is going to be c equals 0. Now let's c equal 1. So let's c equal 1. The level curve at c equal 1 will be x squared plus y squared equal 1. 1 is the same thing as 1 squared. And this is a circle with center 0, 0 and radius 1. So that will be this one. So c equal 1. At c equal 2, x squared plus y squared is equal 2. 2 is the same thing as square root of 2 squared. We get again circle, let me write this, center again 0, 0, but the radius is square root of 2. Square root of 2 is 1.41, so it's kind of like here. C equal 2. What about the level curve or the contour at C equal 3? So if we let C equal 3, we're going to get x squared plus y squared equal 3. 3 is the same thing as square root of 3 squared. Again, we get another circle. C is 0, 0. Radius is square root of 3. Square root of 3 is 1.73. And level curve at c equal 4, x squared plus y squared equal 4. 4 is the same thing as 2 squared. Again, it's a circle with center 0, 0 and radius 2. So, I mean, also, C, since x squared plus y squared is bigger or equal than 0, therefore C has to be bigger or equal than 0. So we cannot use C equal negative number. This will be, we're not going to get any level curve, right? X squared plus y squared cannot be equal negative 1. All right, now for question B, we need to describe those contours and how they are spaced. And of course, those contours are what? They are circles, right? Contours are circles. What else we know about them? We know the center at the origin. So centered at the origin 0, 0 with radius of course square root of c, but what else we know? Yes, we know they become more closely packed. As we move away from the origin, as we move away from the origin. And you can check that. I mean, if you can tell this distance is bigger than this one, is bigger than that one, and so on. And this is even the biggest one. So we went from 1 to 1.41 to 1.73 to 2. So the gate's getting closer and closer. So the level curves are getting closer to each other. All right, what else? Now let's move on to question C. Question C says, graph the cross-section of f at y equals 0. Now here's the definition. The cross-section at x equal a constant a of f of xy is the function z equal f of ay, and we need to graph it. We need to graph the cross-section. So what are we graphing? The cross-section will be z equal f of a happens to be, this is what we mean with a is 0. So y is 0 and x, y is a constant, 0, and x varies. So it's f of x, 0, which means z equal, whatever we see, here's our function, x squared plus y squared, whatever we see, y we plug is 0, x squared plus 0 squared. In other words, we have the function z equal x squared. So this is the cross section at x equals 0. So in other words, we're talking about in yz plane. So yz plane. Xz plane, sorry. Xz plane, y is equal 0. So we get a parabola, so this is it. This is z equal x squared. Now same thing for D, graph the cross-section of f at x equals 0. In other words, the cross-section, the graph of the cross-section will be in yz plane. And it's going to be, again, if you look at the definition right here, it's going to be z equal f of, this time the x is 0 and the y vary. So this will be z equal, whatever you see x, you plug a 0, and then you don't do anything to y. So z equal y squared. Again, it's a parabola. So those are kind of like the traces of the graph at the xz plane and the yz plane. Now, for this question, it says, use the contour along the graphs of the cross section to graph f. So first of all, we know, let me start with the cross section. We know in the y, in the zx, let's start with the yz plane. In the yz plane, we have a parabola. So yz plane will be this parabola. Now, we know in the xz plane, we get also a parabola. Right? And now, we need, try to read this definition. It says, to get the surface of z equal f of xy, we take each contour, f of xy equals c, and lift it above the plane, meaning above the xy plane. Lift it to the height z equals c. So what do we do? For example, how do we lift it? For example, if we're talking about this contour, in other words, this one, x squared plus y squared equal 1, here is z equal 1, so we lift it from here. So it kind of like it was here. Well, anyway, I don't want to mess it up. So it's going to be this one. Right? Now, again, as z equal 2, for example, as z equal 4, we'll get some 4 is here. Also, we get another circle. So, in other words, we're going to get a paraboloid. So this is the graph. And that's it for this example.